So this is the third part of the Anatomy MCQ marathon, which I have started. So let's start with the discussion. Before that, let everyone join. Everyone is joining, and then we will have a brief discussion about the platform and myself. Myself, Dr. Mona Lisa, MBA Anatomy from Armed Force Medical College, Pune, and has got 8 years of teaching experience. And this is my code, ANAT10, which can be used by you for taking the subscription of Unacademy and availing 10% discount, and also for viewing the free sessions on the Unacademy platform. So yeah, this is the unlock code of mine, can be utilized by the students who are downloading the Unacademy app for the first time and they want to be the part of free sessions on the Unacademy platform. Also can be used for taking the subscription of Unacademy. Now, before starting the session, I would like to give you the detail of my my own Telegram group. Mona Lisa Anatomy is my Telegram group. You can join my Telegram group and you can ask Anatomy related doubts in this group, and I will definitely reply. And this is an Anatomy discussion group along with the links of all my free session is provided, all about the plus subscription and the free session. So you can join this. Also the details. So today I have targeted 3 sessions and this is the third session which I am taking. Tomorrow is the 18th July and tomorrow is Sunday. So many of you can have your preparation or you must be at home. So what I have targeted that tomorrow is the morning sessions which I am taking. So starting from 10 a.m. first session, 10 a.m. then 11, then 12 and then 1. Okay, every session will be of 40 to 45 minutes. 40 to 45 minutes. So do join this 4 session, the continuous. So altogether I will take total of 7 sessions completing the Anatomy MCQ marathon. And don't worry, I will not stop here. Again, I will start an evening session. I will give you the updates of my evening session also, provide the link in my own group also, INICT NEET PG Unacademy group, and let's crack NEET PG Unacademy group. So all the links will be provided all on Telegram group of mine, Mona Lisa Anatomy. You can use my code ANAT10 for taking the part of free sessions and also taking the subscription of Unacademy. Now, this is the limited time offer availed by the students who are interested in taking the iconic subscription. The reduced cost is here. So you can use my code for additional 10% discount. I also want to tell how you are going to take the subscription. Download the Unacademy app, and after that downloading, you can find the goal as NEET PG, and then you can avail the opportunity of taking the subscription. Use the code ANAT10 for 10% discount. Now, the plus subscription, the benefits are that that you will have a daily live session. Yes, I know that Unacademy platform has got many of the free live sessions, but my dear friends, that is not in a structured way. The entire course is not free. So if you want your preparation to be at a greater level, targeting the entrance exam in a particular direction, whether it is NEET PG, whether it is NEXT, whether it is INICT, whether it is prof examination, first, second, third year. So you can take this. Good evening, Dr. Baby, good evening. So you can take the subscription and you can use my code ANAT10 for 10% discount. Live test and quizzes are key to the success. Unlimited SS is there. Every 4th session is a doubt clearing session. You will have interaction with the top educators on the Unacademy platform. Now, if we compare the benefits of Iconic, what I suggest, if you want to take the subscription, go for Iconic subscription, because along with the benefits of plus subscription of Unacademy, you get the benefits of Prep Ladder. So you will get a printed notes. It will be provided. It will be shipped to your location. Printed notes will be provided, rapid revision course, Q bank. So all the benefits of Prep Ladder will be add on along with the benefits of plus course. So again, you can avail the opportunity of taking the Iconic subscription and using my code ANAT10. Satyajit, welcome to the session, dear. So the cost of plus and the Iconic subscription is compared here. Just see, have a look. And the code which can be used is ANAT10 for additional 10% discount. Also, I would like to tell you about 4-year subscription, which is extremely beneficial. So that is either it will cost you 60,000 or 75,000 if you go for Iconic, but the benefits are much, much more, because you have the benefits of seeing the free session, targeting your examination for all 4 years duration. That means your prop examination will be cleared along with the next examination. So do part and take this subscription, extremely beneficial. 10% will be the discounted if you use the code ANAT10. Okay, the benefits of Now, which is added on the platform of Unacademy, take 2 months of subscription at the rate of 6,750. Boost your preparation by taking 12 months of subscription and get additional 2 months absolutely free. Also, what you can see, professional third year batch is coming up. Actually, in this batch, the first year prof subject along with the second year prof subject is completing. I am taking the entire anatomy along with the top educators. And if you target the first year subject, physiology, biochemistry, and anatomy, whole will be covered. Take the subscription, use the code ANATIN and be the part of my sessions. It will target you with good marks in the university examination, preparation of the theory part and the practical examination, along with the preparation of next, along with the preparation of next. Now, other batches which is coming up is last mile of NEET PG 2021 preparation, the integrated clinical courses of NEET PG 2021. Use the code ANAT10. Integrated clinical batch of NEET PG 2021. All these batches are taken by the top educators on the Unacademy platform. Focus FMG batch and target next 2022 batch. So any of this course which suits you, be the part of this session. Let's start with the first MCQ. Let's start with the MCQ session. All the best to everyone. All of the following nuclei belong to general visceral efferent except. Question number one. All of the following nuclei belong to general visceral efferent, okay, except, which is the right answer. Your time begins now. So yes, the correct answer is given by 50% of the students, and the correct answer is nucleus of tractus solitarius. Nucleus of tractus solitarius is not the correct answer because it is not belonging to general visceral. Yes, it is. The nucleus of tractus solitarius is belonging to special visceral afferent and general visceral afferent. It is belonging to, it is the nucleus of two functional columns, special visceral afferent and general visceral afferent. Rest all, Edinger, Festfall, lacrimator, dorsal nucleus of vagus, along with superior and inferior salivatory nucleus. So inferior salivatory nucleus, all these nucleus are belong to general visceral efferent, which is carrying preganglionic parasympathetic fibers. Preganglionic parasympathetic fibers. So yes, let's move on to the second MCQ, question number second. Extensor carpi radialis longest tendon is crossed by which of the following two muscles? Extensor carpi radialis longest tendon is crossed by which of the two muscles? Question number second. Whether it is abductor pollicis longus. So please read the option nicely and mark the correct answer. Five options are there. You just read the option and mark the correct answer. Your time begins now. Yeah, many of the students have given right answer. So yes, I have got many students who are replying right. 68% good score dear. And the correct answer is D. Abductor pollicis longus and extensor pollicis brevis is the correct answer. Question number second. B is the correct option. I will show you a diagram which will clear this. Image, ma'am. Yes, Dr. Baby, see this image. Okay, baby. So see here. This is extensor carpi radialis longest tendon. Can you see here? This is ECRL tendon. Now, can you appreciate this muscle tendon? If I will use green color for this muscle tendon, can you see that this muscle tendon is crossed above Y? So let me use purple color for this. So these two muscle tendons are crossing over extensor carpi radialis longus. One is extensor pollicis brevis and the other is abductor pollicis longus. So ECRL, as shown in the diagram, is crossed over by, it is crossed over by two muscle tendons. One is abductor pollicis longus, other is extensor pollicis brevis. Is it okay, Dr. Baby? So yes, this is the correct answer. And many of you have given the right answer. Let's move on to the next MCQ. Question number third. Which structure forms the mesentery of uterus? Which of the following structure forms the mesentery of uterus? Whether it is round ligament of uterus, mesosalphenics, pelvic diaphragm, endopelvic fascia, or mesometrium? Question number three, please mark the correct answer. Your time begins now. Question number three. So yes, approximately 35% students has given the right answer, and the correct answer here is mesometrium. Actually, the option which is provided, if we see the mesentery of uterus, it is formed by a part of broad ligament. It is formed by the part of broad ligament, and the major part of broad ligament part is called as mesometrium, which is hanging on the sides of the uterus and which is forming the mesentery of uterus. Okay, so I would like to show you a diagram for it. See here, this is a diagram which is showing the parts of broad ligament. So here you can see the major part. Let me use a highlighter for here. So you can see this part, which is onto the attaching to the sides of uterus and cervix and going towards the lateral pelvic wall. This major part is mesometrium, which is behaving as the mesentery of the broad ligament. The other parts is mesosalpinx. So the part of the broad ligament lying below the fallopian tube, this is mesosalpinx. Okay. And the other part is mesovarium, which is holding the ovary, forming a peritoneum covering of the ovary. This is mesovarium. And this part, which is entering into the ovary, this extended part is called as suspensory ligament or endopelvic fascia, which is called as endopelvic ligament for that of the part of broad ligament. So mesometrium is the correct answer. So let's move on to question number four. Question number four. Okay, a line which is drawn, a line drawn from anterior superior iliac spine to that of ischial tuberosity, which is called as Nelaton's line, is passing over lateral aspect of hip, is crossing which of the following structure? Whether it is sciatic nerve? Yes, four parts. Yes, dear. Sciatic, ischial spine, obturator canal, pudendal nerve, and greater trochanter. So what is the correct answer? Yes, yes, Dr. Bobby, it is having four parts, broad ligament, which I have mentioned before. Yeah. So please mark the correct answer, question number four. So yes, we have got 33% students are correct. Okay, yeah. So greater trochanter is the correct answer. So I will show you a diagram. Actually, in the initial times when there was not much of advanced X-ray techniques and all, clinical examination was done to see whether there is any kind of displacement or dislocations in the case of hip joint and all. So for that purpose, this Nelaton's line was used. Okay, it is a part of clinical examination. So let's see if you draw. So I have written the definition of Nelaton's line. A line when it is drawn from ASIS, what is this ASIS? ASIS means anterior superior iliac spine of the hip joint, which is going towards this ischial tuberosity, the part of the hip bone on which we keep our weight when we are sitting over it. And this part is connected by a line. What you can see, it is crossing over which prominence? It is crossing over the greater trochanter of the femur. It is crossing over the topmost part or the superior aspect of greater trochanter of femur. So this is all about Nelaton's line. Let's move on to the next one. Which of the following is not found in the floor of fourth ventricle? Which of the following is not found in the floor of fourth ventricle? Whether it is hypoglossal triangle, vagal triangle, facial colliculus, or medullary vellum. Please mark the correct answer. So yes, we have got 38% students are right. Actually, the correct answer is medullary vellum. So we have got two medullary vellums. One is superior and the other is inferior medullary vellum. And these medullary vellums, which is connecting the parts of the cerebellum and stretching across the, and this is actually medullary vellums are forming the part of the roof of the fourth ventricle, not the floor. The floor is having many important structures, hypoglossal vagal triangle and facial colliculus. Okay, facial colliculus, facial nerve fibers is looping around the abducens nerve and it is called as facial colliculus. So all these structures which is mentioned here is the part which is found in the floor. Only medullary vellum is the part which is forming the roof of fourth ventricle. So see here, the structures forming the floor. The floor of fourth ventricle is formed by the posterior aspect of the pons and the medulla, which is having medial eminences, sulcus terminalis, facial colliculus, vagal triangle, hypoglossal triangle, and the stria medullaris. When you see the roof, what you can see, the roof is formed, as you can see, the structure forming the roof is superior medullary velum and inferior medullary velum. Superior medullary velum is shown here, and lower down is inferior medullary velum, which is also having tilacoroida, and through this tilacoroida, choroid plexus is protruding. Let's move on to the next one. Interpeduncular fossa contains all of the following structure except. Question number six, interpeduncular fossa contains all of the following structure except. Your time starts now. Four options are there. Mark the correct answer. Question number six. So yes, we have got 58% students has given the right answer. Actually, the correct answer is trochlear nerve. This is also previous year MCQ for the NEET PGs. And actually, trochlear nerve is not a content for interpeduncular fossa. Rest all structure which is mentioned, posterior perforated substance, oculomotor nerve, and mammillary bodies are the content of interpeduncular fossa. Question number six. Actually, interpeduncular fossa, I will show you the boundaries and the content. So it is bounded by, as you can see, anteriorly optic nerve, optic tract, optic chiasma, also the cerebral peduncles on either side, and this whole structure, which is interpeduncular fossa. It is having mammillary body inside, tuber cinereum, posterior perforated substance is lying here, and oculomotor nerve. One more diagram is here. See here. This is the area of interpeduncular area. It is containing oculomotor nerve as shown. And it is containing posterior perforated substance, stalk of the infundibulum, infundibulum stalk, you can see posterior perforated substance, oculomotor nerve. These are the important structure which is lying. So can you see this is trochlear nerve? So it is exactly not in the content, it is lying more laterally. What you can see, it is lying more laterally. This area is only the interpeduncular fossa, which is lying between the crux cerebri and the optic tract and optic chiasma. See here, this area which is containing posterior perforated substance, tuber cinereum is also located here, and the third cranial nerve and that of posterior perforated substance, but not the fourth cranial nerve. So the correct answer here will be fourth cranial nerve. D is the correct option. Everyone, is it okay? Can we move on to the next MCQ? That is question number seven. Done? Pineal gland forms, question number seven, pineal gland forms which boundary of the third ventricle? It is related and forming which boundary of third ventricle? So floor, anterior wall, posterior wall, or roof? Your time begins now. Question number seven. So yes, we have got 28% of the students has marked it right. The correct answer is posterior wall of third ventricle. Posterior wall of third ventricle. Pineal gland is forming posterior wall of third ventricle. So I would like to show you a diagram for it. See here, this is a diagram showing relations of third ventricle. So here you can see, if we will see posterior aspect, this whole structure which is highlighted here, you can see here, this is the fourth ventricle and this hole is the third ventricle. So posteriorly, it is having the relation of pineal gland, posterior commissure. Superiorly, it is having the column of fornix and the anterior aspect, lamina terminalis, optic chiasma. This is onto the floor. It is more onto the anterior aspect, and then going more inferiorly, it is having floor structure, hypophysis cerebelli, mammillary body, posterior perforated substance, and tegment tympani. So what you can see in this layout, what was asked in the MCQ about the pineal gland, and clearly in this diagram, we can see the pineal gland is forming posterior boundary of third ventricle, posterior boundary of third ventricle. Is it okay, everyone? Can we move on to the next MCQ? Question number eight. Yes, let's move on to question number eight. Medulla oblongata is supplied by which of the following arteries? Except it is having blood supply from following arteries except, which is not providing the blood supply to medulla oblongata. Your time starts now. Question number eight. So yes, 58% students has given the right answer. Actually, the correct answer is posterior cerebral artery. Posterior cerebral artery is providing blood supply basically to the occipital lobe of the cerebral hemisphere, basically. Okay. And if we talk about anterior spinal artery and the basilar, vertebral, and posterior inferior cerebral artery, these are providing major blood supply. These are major source of blood supply to the medulla. I will show you a diagram for it where you can appreciate this. Now see here, this is a diagram which is showing that medulla is getting, this is a cut section of the medulla, transverse section. What you can see, this is getting blood supply from posterior spinal artery, anterior spinal artery, dorsolateral front from the posterior inferior cerebral artery and also vertebral artery. Two vertebral arteries of either side joins to form the basilar artery. So all these arteries are providing blood supply to medulla except posterior cerebral artery, which was given as one of the options. So posterior cerebral artery is the correct answer, not providing blood supply to medulla. Let's move on to question number 9. This was the question asked in 2019. AIMS entrance examination. Lesion of the marked structure in the given image could lead to the which of the following features? Okay, so can you see arrow mark structure? So please, after seeing that area, you just tell me what will be the clinical presentation of the patient. Four options are there. Mark the correct answer. Question number 9. Okay, so yes, 50% students has given the right answer. Approximately 50% contralateral hemiplegia is the correct answer. The area which is shown here is the medulla part. And what you can see on the lower aspect of medulla, there is crossing over. There is the crossing of the corticospinal fibers here. And this will lead to an abnormality that is called as contralateral hemiplegia. So the correct answer is D. Okay, is it okay, everyone? Can we move on to next MCQ? Is it okay? Yes, let's move on to the next MCQ, that is MCQ number 10. Now, blood supply of the structure marked in the given image. So you have to identify firstly the arrow mark structure in this image, and then you have to tell me what is the blood supply of this area, whether it is internal carotid, vertebral, anterior cerebral, or middle cerebral artery. Your time starts now. Question number 10. Question number 10, four options are there. And please mark the correct answer. Okay, so yes. So yes, we have got 19% students. So nothing to worry. If certain mistake is also there, what is good point that we are knowing new things. Actually, the first thing is that you have to identify the structure. This structure is fornix. Okay, fornix is an important part of the efferent. It is a path for the projection fibers, also containing the commensural and afferent fibers. So this fornix is getting blood supply from basically from anterior cerebral artery. Okay, fornix. Okay. So fornix, see here, fornix is a part of limbic system also. This structure which you are seeing is the fornix. And how you can locate, it is lying just below. This is corpus callosum. And this is the cavity of lateral ventricle. This is the cavity of lateral ventricle. Below it, the structure which is lying is the fornix. The blood supply of the fornix is, fornix gets its blood supply. So those who have made a mistake, please note down this. Fornix derives its blood supply mainly from the short medial central arteries such as branches of proximal anterior cerebral artery. Proximal anterior cerebral artery ke branches fornix ko blood supply dete hai, and it is having 4 to 10 in number, and it enters the brain through the area of anterior perforated substance. Anterior perforated substance is the source where the blood is traversing from anterior cerebral artery, giving blood supply to fornix. Moving on to the next one, question number 11. So tract absent in the superior cerebellar peduncle. So what would I would suggest that question number 11 and question number 12. So we will go on with the answers of question number 11 and question number 12 together. Why? Because I want to explain all the, just the name of the tracts, just the afferents and efferents of all the three cerebral peduncles. So we will move on with the answers together. Question number 11, you have to give the right answer. Okay. So all of you, please mark the right answer. So your time starts now. Question number 11. Yeah. Don't worry, I will give you. Okay, yeah, 35% students has given the right answer. Good score. At the end, I will show you the leaderboard also, don't worry. Now let's move on to question number 12. So don't worry, the list of afferents and efferents fibers, which is passing between the peduncles. We have got superior and we have got inferior cerebral peduncles and middle cerebral peduncles. So my concern is that I will give you the name of afferents and efferents of these peduncles. What are peduncles forming a connecting link between the cerebellum and that of parts of brainstem, medulla, pons, and midbrain. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Structure not passing through inferior cerebral peduncle. Which of the following structure is not passing through inferior cerebral peduncle? Your time starts now. So yes, we have got 39% students are right. So what I am feeling actually that many of you have got confusion in this peduncle. So it will hardly take 2 to 3 minutes. Let me write and all of you please note down this. All of you please note down the afferents and efferents passing through the three peduncles. Those who have made a mistake because I wanted to be corrected. Actually, the correct answer here for the question number 11, if we talk about 11, is D. Dorsal spinocerebral is not passing through superior, but it is passing through ICP, inferior cerebral peduncle. And in question number 12, pontocerebral is the answer. Pontocerebral is passing through middle cerebral peduncle. So it is not passing through inferior cerebral peduncle. Let me give you the list. All of you, please complete the list of the afferents, efferents, fibers, which is passing through superior, inferior, and that of middle cerebral peduncle. So please note down, everyone. So please write down about superior cerebellar peduncle. SCP, I am writing in short. Superior cerebellar peduncle. Superior cerebral peduncle, afferents. So the afferents of superior cerebral peduncle is, write down the name of the afferents. It is ventral spinocerebellar. It is ventral spinocerebellar. And also tectocerebellar. Tectocerebellar. Efferents. Just write down the name of efferents passing through superior cerebral peduncle. The efferents are dentatorubrothalamic, dentato-olivary, and festigo-reticular. Okay, so please note down S. Superior cerebellar peduncle. What is superior cerebellar peduncle? The afferents and the efferents fibers which is connecting midbrain with that of cerebellum. So through its afferents are ventral spinocerebral and efferents are ventral spinocerebral and tectocerebral is the afferent. Efferents are dentato rubro, dentato olivary, and festigo reticular. Now, my dear friends, one relief is that middle cerebral peduncle se sirf afferents pass karta hai. Okay, so one relief is that if we talk about middle cerebellar peduncle, what is middle cerebral peduncle? It is formed of connecting fibers, which is connecting cerebellum and the pons. It is forming a connecting link between cerebellum and pons. And through it, only afferent fibers passes, only afferents, and only one fibers passes. Most importantly, the fibers are pontocerebellar. What is the, it is forming the pathway of cortico-pontocerebellar pathway. Done. Now I want you to give the details of the fibers which is passing from inferior cerebellar peduncle. Write down inferior cerebellar peduncle. The fibers passing are, firstly, please write down the list of afferents. Inferior cerebral peduncle is forming a connecting link between afferents and efferents fibers, which is forming a connecting link between medulla and that of cerebellum. The fibers which is passing is, please write down the name of the fibers. Have friends. Dorsal spino cerebellar. Dorsal spino cerebellar. Olivo cerebellar. Par olivo cerebellar. Reticulo cerebellar. Reticulo cerebellar. Vestibulo cerebellar. Anterior external arcuate fibers. Anterior external arcuate fibers. And cuneocerebellar. Cuneocerebellar. Which is posterior external arcuate fibers. And also trigeminocerebellar. Trigeminocerebellar. Please complete this list. Okay, these are the afferents and efferents. Also part of this triamedullaris. So many of the afferents, please write down the complete list. So please write down all the afferents, all the list of the afferents which is passing through inferior cerebral peduncle, because it is has been asked in the previous years. What I have seen in the previous year MCQ mein maine dekha hai, cerebellum se ke wo afferent efferent fibers ke sirf name hi poochte hain. So you have to just have a list of that name. So inferior cerebral peduncle se bahut sare afferents pass karte hain. Please write down the name. Dorsal spino, olivo, par olivo, vestibulo, reticulo cerebellum, anterior external arcuate fibers, cuneocerebellar, trigemino cerebellum and stria medullaris. And efferents also. Efferents, it's a small list. Please write down the name of efferents also. Okay, I will come to this point. So have you completed the afferents? Everyone, have you completed the afferents? Let me give you the list of efferents. So I will write here. Please write down inferior cerebral peduncle efferents. I am using this inferior cerebral peduncle efferents name are cerebellovestibular. Cerebello olivary and that of cerebellareticular. So three important one, please write down the name of efferents through ICP inferior cerebral peduncle is cerebellovestibular, cerebello olivary, cerebelloreticular. Cerebellovestibular, cerebello olivary and cerebello vestibular. So we have done with afferents and efferents. Now I want to go on to the next MCQ, that is MCQ number 13. Okay, let's move on to 13th number MCQ. Relations of internal capsules are, so please go through all the four options and mark the correct answer. Question number 13. Please go through all the four options and mark the correct answer. So yes, great. We have got 35% students has given the right answer. The correct answer is C. The correct answer is C. Thalamus and caudate nucleus is lying on the medial aspect and lentiform nucleus is lying laterally. So how you can remember L for lateral and L for lentiform nucleus. L for lateral and L for lentiform nucleus. Caudate and thalamus will lie on the medial aspect. Let me show you the diagram. These fibers which you are seeing in the part of internal capsule, it is having anterior limb, genu, posterior limb, sublentiform and retrolentiform. The lentiform nucleus which is shown in the green color is forming is lying on its lateral side, and thalamus and caudate nucleus both are lying on its medial side. Example, internal capsule is which type of fibers? It is projection fibers. Now see here, I would also like all of you, what I have included this diagram or image, it is showing the fibers which is passing through different parts of internal capsule. So this diagram is very useful. Go through it and see the location of fibers and the tracks. Corticonuclear tract kaha jata hai, corticospinal tract where it is traversing. So all I have included by the use of this diagram, you can revise the location of all the types of tracts and the fibers which is located in different parts of internal capsule. So you can revise this by the use of this image. everyone. Okay, lateral geniculate body is related to optic radiation and medial geniculate body to acoustic radiation. So all this you can revise by seeing this image. Let's move on to the next one. Action, okay, association fibers are all except. So which of the following here is not an example of association fibers? Association fibers. Your time starts now. Question number 14. So yes, we have got 33% students are correct. Okay. So actually the correct answer is forceps major. So can anybody tell me forceps major is a part of which fibers? Forceps major is a part of which fibers? Anyone? Anyone? Forceps major is the part of which fibers? It's a part of corpus callosum. And corpus callosum is a part of which fibers? Commissural fibers. What do you mean by the word commissural fibers? Commissural fibers ka matlab hota hai the fibers which is connecting one side of hemisphere with the other side. Means commissural fibers is forming a connection, connecting link between right and the left side of cerebral hemisphere. Okay, got it. So it's the right answer is C. It is an example of commissural fibers, not association fiber. What do you mean by association fibers, which is connecting same parts of same hemisphere, different areas of same hemisphere? So that is uncinate cingulum and longitudinal fasciculus. See here, I have included this diagram which is showing you the names of different kind of association fibers. See here, it is located in one cerebral hemisphere. The fibers are located in one cerebral hemisphere only. It is not crossing the cerebral hemisphere, and the fibers are superior longitudinal short fibers, cingulum, uncinate one, association fibers, inferior longitudinal. So all the names of association fibers are written here. Now this is a diagram. Here you can see green color is used for corpus callosum, and these fibers are connecting one cerebral hemisphere with the other. It is connecting right side cerebral hemisphere with the left side. Okay, and this pink color is the projection fibers. One of the most important example is internal capsule fornix. These are all example of projection, which is connecting the cortical area with the subcortical area. Okay, so here now all of the following are the parts of corpus callosum except. All of the followings are the parts of corpus callosum except. So yes, question number 15, mark the correct answer. So yes, I got 59% students are correct. So good score, dear. So Manish Kumar Singh has leaded 12 correct out of 15. Good score, Manish. Asima. So everyone has performed nice. Anshad, Preeti, Akshit, Himansu, Harini, Alok, Shriya, Yogita. Great. So the correct answer is Indusium griseum. Indusium griseum is a part of gray matter. It is not a part of white matter. Actually, all the fibers, association fibers, commissural fibers, projection fibers, all are the part of white matter. Tepictum, forceps major, forceps minus, all these are the parts of corpus callosum. All these are the parts of corpus callosum, not the indusium griseum. Now see here, this is the corpus callosum CC, which is shown in yellow color, and its parts are here. The anterior part is called as genu. Lower down, this part is called as rostrum, beak-like projection. This is called as the trunk or the body, trunk on the body, and posteriorly, this part is called as the splenium. So these are the terms which is used for different parts of corpus callosum. Also, you can see its projection. Green color structure in horizontal section is showing you the parts of corpus callosum. So anteriorly, the fibers are of corpus callosum going to the frontal lobe is forming forceps minor. Posteriorly, you can see it is forming forceps major. Okay, and also forming topectum. So these three structures which is shown are the parts of corpus callosum. Got it, everyone? Now, before ending the session, I would also like to tell you about Indusium griseum, which is supracallosal gyrus, which is consists of membranous gray matter, which is lying in the upper aspect of corpus callosum. It is lying very close and to the upper aspect of corpus callosum, but it is not the part of corpus callosum. It's a made of gray matter. Got it, everyone? Definition of Indusium griseum as noted. Those who want to revise can note down. Okay, my dear friends, before ending the session, be the part of my free session and take the subscription of Unacademy by using my code and discount. Now, I want to tell you about my Telegram group where the link of all free session is provided. 10% discount by get by using this subscription code. And tomorrow, all of you do present for tomorrow, Sunday session. We will have many, many Anatomy MCQs discussed starting from 10 a.m. and ending on 1 p.m. So in between, I will give 15 minutes break. So four session I have targeted tomorrow, four session. I will give you 15 minutes break in between. Link of all the session will be provided in my own group, Telegram group, Mona Lisa Anatomy. Join this for the links of my session. Referral code is ANAT10. Use this code for taking the plus subscription and for being the part of free session. 10% discount will be availed. So my plus subscription is coming, plus classes on 21st July. It is coming 21st July. Interactive session will be it. And all of the third year prof batch, second year and first year prof batch courses will be covered. Anatomy, physiology, and that of biochemistry along with the different subjects. 6 months subscription is enough, and whole of the theory and practical examination will be done along with the next preparation. Those who want to take the subscription can use my code and add 10 for 10% discount and can be the part of the session. Your preparation of the university exam along with that next preparation will be done. So I am taking entire anatomy in this along with the top educators of Unacademy platform. So this is 4 year subscription rate, which can be availed by you if you are interested for Iconic subscription or plus subscription, and 10% discount by using my code. And this is the comparison of plus rates with that of free rates, plus rate with that of plus subscription rates with Iconic subscription. And you can avail the opportunity according to your needs, according to your preparation. If you are in the first year, what I suggest, go for 4 year subscription at one time, because this will give you an opportunity to have whole preparation of prop examination along with the targeting of the next examination. So all the best students, do join for the special sessions. This is all rates of this. And add 10 is the code which will give you additional 10% discount. What I want to tell that these are tomorrow's free sessions starting from morning 10 a.m. 10 a.m. first session, 11 a.m. second session, third session 12 p.m. and last session 1 p.m. Asuteus, you are the best, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Asutos. So all of you do present for this, and I will continue your NEET PG preparation MCQ session revision constantly. I will give you another. So this is the timing of the tomorrow's morning session. Again, I will give you the details of my upcoming session. So 1 hour or 40-45 minutes day, each day. All the best. Thank you so much. We'll meet tomorrow morning with the MCQ sessions. Present, all of you. All of you do present. Thank you so much. Thank you, students. Thank you. These are all details, okay? Those who have missed out the MCQ session can watch it, okay? Can watch it. And tomorrow morning, too, absolutely, we will start from morning 10 a.m. So do present here. So till now we have completed the third part only, but I have targeted together 7 parts of the MCQ marathon. That is tomorrow. I will continue this session and marathon existing, continuing with the sessions whole of the month of July, and then come up with the, till your examination, this free sessions of MCQ session will continue. All the best. Keep studying. Thank you so much. Thank you, students.